are probably the most underutilised fish in New Zealand waters, and they are the small tunas, the albacore tuna and the skipjack tuna.
We've got quite a lot of fish.
I would say there's a bit of processing work involved.
I've got no idea.
Hey mate, what I'm after is a wood chipper.
Okay, it's brand new there, so look out for it,
eh? Yeah mate, no worries.
Albacore, skipjack tuna, excellent bait and excellent burley. Right, hit it, Pete. Oh, not bad. Not bad for a starter. First bait into the Burley Trail. Might be a carboy. The old strip of skipjack tuna. See all those hard hours dodging marlin, or trying to dodge marlin, to catch skipjack tuna is worth it. Because we might catch a feeder fish to take home. What have we got? Oh, it's a big trevally, is it? Or a rat kingfish? Oh, rat kingy. Took a dead bait, it's unusual. Still, it's nice to be hooked up. It's a change from the summer of game fishing. Oh, you get such a scrap out of these little kingies. They've obviously responded to our burley trail. Here he is. Let's try and get his head up. Okay, we'll get him on the deck. Get his eyes covered up and then I'll just swap that hook out. Another stunning little kingy going back to fight another day, and there's no shortage of tuna for him to eat out there. Right, time for some more burley, Pete. Kick her in the guts, mate.
You got him on over there.
Hopefully a snapper. Hopefully a snapper. Spotting straight up and down, eh? Oh yeah, nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that, Pete. Look at that.
Yes.
The burley, eh?
Yeah.
Beautiful, mate. That's a
Thank
stunning eater.
Much.
So that's payoff for catching all those skipjack tuna. Although skipjack and albacore are good eating in their own right, particularly albacore. But we just like snapper fishing, don't we, Pete?
That's right, mate.
There's Marco. See that little Marco?
Whereabouts?
He just swam in the back of the boat.
Oh, yep, choice.
A little tiny one.
You might follow your fish up.
What are you doing?
Oh, right here, look. Eating the burley.
Might be one of those kings, eh?
Rat king.
Yeah, it's a king.
Oh, a little rat. Another one, another victim to the burley.
How's that? The burley's working well, mate.
Now basically what we're doing here is we've got our wood chipper that's just fired tons of burley out there, and it's floating away mainly on the surface and slowly floating down. So we're stray lining baits back that's sort of floating along in amongst all of that, and what we're hoping is for some bigger snapper. And well, me and Pete have been catching a couple of smaller ones. I've got Jeff rigged up on the 24 kilo tackle holding tight, and I said just be patient, put out that big bait once the burley starts working and you might have a good shot at that 20 pounder.
Hopefully. Patience.
Picked up, here we go, here we go. Ferocious stroke for Pete. Ferocious. Mate, you're going to want the bottom to slow down, mate, or if you are going to let him go, you'll be blown up. Oh, nice. Nice, Pete. Oh, that's a good one. Oh, Jeff's got a good one.
Oh, yeah.
Bit of a run. Give him You're not going to break the line. Go to sunset, mate. That's a donkey. Oh, you run you to the ground. That was a donkey, mate. That was a donkey. No worries, still down there, mate. Well, you might not see him again, but there might be another big one. Mate, deuce, 80-pound tray smashed. And Jeff just got cleaned up on 24-kilo tackle, and I'm going to cast out my 8kg tackle. There you go, Pete, there you go. Show him. Smash olid, mate.
I think it busted off me.
Yeah, running to the ground. Oh, something's hitting my strip baits. Got him on. I'm getting smoked, man. I'm getting smoked. This is a donkey, mate. This is a donkey. Oh no, I've got no show. I'm gonna get smashed. He's on the bottom now. On this light gear. This is gonna be tough. How that fish hasn't rubbed me off already, I don't know. Oh, come on, hold on. It's holding together somehow. Come on, baby. Oh, mate, look at all the fish swimming around our burley trail. Stalemate at the moment, I can't lift them. What if it's a shark? Or a big donkey snapper. If it is a snapper, mate, it's huge. Excuse me, I'm gonna have to come over the wood chipper. Over the old wood chipper. It's heading up towards the anchor, might be a big king. Oh well. Oh no, it's got the nod. Yeah. Mate, how this braid held together, I don't know. I think a lot of credit's got to go to this gear. The smooth drag of the Trinidad and these T-Curve T-Series rods. It's just sort of not doing a snapper thing at the moment. Sort of just a heavy weight on this gear. Whoa, just dug in. Oh, I can see it down there. It's big, whatever it is. It's blooming big. Oh, it's a stingray. It's a ray. How could I handle that on this gear? Awesome. Just shorten them right up. We'll get a look at them, see what sort of ray he is. Just grab that sinker and cut that second hook so he doesn't get stuck with that hook, Pete. If you can, just hold your rod. Just watch you don't get your hook in your hand. Okay, nice and close to him, so he has a fair fighting chance. The old stinger, watch that tail, mateys, and away he goes. Whew, that was a bit of fun on the skier, mate.
Yeah.
Here's this, can handle a bit of load. Stoked. Pete, ferocious stroke for Pete. Go, Pete! Right. Bait with him! There's some donkeys down there. That's still smoking line out, mate.
Yeah, mate.
Oh, shivers. Mate, they're smashing into those big chunks of skipjack tuna and albacore tuna we're throwing down. Oh, that's smoking. You just got to hang on and hope, mate. Okay, tighten that. You're not getting any wines there, mate. You're not getting any wines. Oh, mate, actually, you might have rolled him over. Keep going, keep working him. Oh, get the facial, gotta get those facials. Come on, baby.
Oh, you got him off the bottom, have you?
Yeah.
Want to grab that net, Jeffrey? He might have a chance here, actually. I thought he was gone for all money on that first run.
Yeah, mate.
What do we got? Snapperoonie. Oh, it's a nice one. Jeez, that was a powerful fish. That was a goer. Oh, nice one.
Grab that bait, mate. He was gone.
Yeah, hi, mate. That was a screamer.
Yeah.
Mate, and they're just getting bigger and bigger.
Nice fish, that.
That is a very nice one.
A couple of fillets off him.
Oh, here we go. Here we go. On me. Something's picked up my bait.
Oh, ferocious strike.
Oh, got a wood chipper in me, Rode. Great for attracting snapper. Not so good once you're hooked up to them. Every boat should have one, though.
Whoa, yeah!
What a sesh. What a sesh. Mate, this is a smash. Every bait's getting smashed, mate.
Yeah.
Now, you've seen how it was done. All we started with was a couple of those little wee skippy lures and some hand lines. Whoa. And while they're great sport in their own right, they obviously make pretty good bill and bait. Oi, oi. It's a kingfish. Scrounging around down there on the bottom with the snappers, that one. Now, just watch me rise. Cheers, mate. I'll just. You're right, there's two hooks there, mate, so be careful.
Burley's working well, mate.
Well, a few more bigger ones soon, hopefully.
Yeah.
Well, the fishing's slowed down a wee bit now, and I think that's largely due to the fact that our Burley trail has died down. There was a whole flurry of fish. Our underwater cameraman saw a snapper and all sorts of stuff feeding down there now. So we better get it cranked up. Here we go. Oh, you over here, look. Oh, yeah, you got him, Jeff. It's a nice one.
Yeah.
Oh, mate. Oh, you got him on, all right.
It's only a little fella.
Is he? Well, he's on 24 kilo line, mate, so he's going to have no show getting away. Oh, only little, you were saying. Get him off the bottom, buddy. Now, you may remember Jeff here trying to catch his first 20-pounder on our show. It's, whoa, he's done a few firsts on our show, his young Jeff. First marlin, widest first marlin.
Yeah.
And I've just rigged him up a 24 kilo set and said, mate, if you get the big one on, ain't going nowhere. It's a snapper, mate, it's a nice one, I'm telling you that much. Well, I mean, it's fighting up and down. Is it fighting up and down? Is it consistently pulling the
little rat kingy, eh?
Might be a kingy.
Right under the boat.
Yeah, you're right, mate, hang on. Getting another run over here. We got a wood chipper in the road of the cameraman. You're all right. Not your traditional snapper fishing setup, but hey, it's paying dividends. Oh, mate, this is just no quarter. This fish hasn't been given a chance to run. 24 kilo gear, lock and load, dog. That fish still got heaps of fight today. Ooh, it's a big one. This is gonna be a celebration. Yeah. It's gonna go close to your 20 pound. Just take your time. I think you got your. Think you got your 20 pounder, mate. There's your 20 pounder right there.
Get
out. There you go. All it took was about 70 or 80 kilos of skipjack tuna. What did I tell you when I made that rig up? That's the one that'll get the 20 pounder. And we'll just show you exactly what this rig is. This rig consists of a whole mackerel that we caught. Now what he's smashed up in those big powerful jaws there is a mackerel. He's got 2 9-bar-0 VMC hooks. We've got an 80 pound leader, and you'll notice how long the leader is. It's really, really long, right tied down onto this 24 kg line. When you're in gnarly rocky country like we are here, this is the sort of gear you need to pull him away. And look how bulging his guts is. Now, it isn't spawning season right now. I'm picking, he's full of skipjack tuna.
I got my 20 pounder.
Yeah. Now you'll see here, this fish that pulverized this bait. Look at those sharp teeth up front, and those molars are crushing down back. And just a great big jack mackerel, pulverized it. That's all that's left of a really big mackerel. And I said to Jeff, just bide your time. Then when the burley trail kicks off, there'll be some small fish around. There'll be some big ones working their way up, feeding on all that skipjack tuna. Now I'm just going to pick them up nicely for you, mate, so you can get a photo.
How good is that? Ready?
That is awesome, man. That looks awesome there, mate. Captured to save it forever. Now I'm just keeping this fish alive in the water here, just holding him in the net, just so we can get some water across his gills. Jeff is understandably stoked about catching his first 20 pound snapper. I'm sure it's gonna go over 20. He says if it goes over 25, he wants to get a mount done, which so many guys do. They look stunning mounted on the wall. But of course, we need to weigh him. So if we get this, I'll weigh him in the net. Okay, and then we'll do them without the net. I don't think he's going to quite go 25, but there's only one way to find out for sure. Even with the net, he's not 25, mate.
Oh, bugger.
He's 11 kilos, so probably 10.5 without the net. So I would say 10.5 kilos, that's 21, 2.1, that's, geez, 23 and a half. Good fish, mate, but you're cool, mate.
Nah, sweet, chuck him back.
Let him go, good call. You put him back, mate, as your fish.
He starts feeling like he's going to
come. Well, our underwater cameraman's following him down. If he's not going to make it, well, he's going to bring him back to us. He can hold his breath for a long time.
Awesome.
How good was that, brother?
Awesome,
hey?
Man.
Hey?
Awesome, man. It was awesome to
let
him go.
Worth all those skippies? Yeah, it's good to see them swim away. I mean, hey, it was your call totally, mate. But, you know, it gives you something to go for, that one on the wall. Now you've had a taste.
All good.
We're looking for something to eat. We're hunting, we're fishing, cause we like to eat fish and meat. Now we're cooking, we're cooking with Matt and Pete. It's cooking with Matt and Pete. It's cooking with Matt and Pete.
G'day, welcome to what is hopefully the last installment of Cooking with Matt and Pete. Today we've got a great recipe that is able to utilize our fresh albacore. I've got a couple of beautiful fillets here, some lemon and some pepper and salt. Ingredients that we'd probably expect to be in a fish dish. But we've got a couple of other very special ingredients that you might not expect to see. Namely cabbages and also some carrots. That's right, these are key ingredients in that dish that we all love, that family dish, coleslaw. So, it doesn't take long at all to whip up, so Pete, if you'd like to go and get ready to serve up, I'm just going to trim the dark meat out of these fillets. Now, we bled these albacore, so there's not a lot of this dark meat, but we take it out because we don't need any heat at all. We don't have to cook this meal. Right, now that is all our ingredients ready to go. Now, we're just about ready to combine everything, and this comes together beautifully. Presentation is key on this. Are you ready, Peter?
Yeah, mate.
We like to combine all of the ingredients at once so they blend together fairly nicely. The trick is to really keep things moving so you get a nice even blend of ingredients as they go through. Of course, the fish is key. A little bit of lemon juice just to offset the flavour. A little bit of zest as well. The whole lemon, in fact, the whole lemon can go in. And of course, a key ingredient to any good coleslaw is mayonnaise. Don't be shy to sort of lay it on. Nice and straight. A little bit of pepper and salt, just to taste. Is there enough salt in there, Pete?
More salt, mate.
More salt, rightio. There you have it, fresh tuna coleslaw.
Bon appetit.
It's cooking with Matt and Pete.